So let's consider the mole and the mole mantra. First, we want to look at some images. What do these images have in common? Write down some commonalities. In each case, we saw that we had a triangle. These triangles are summarized on this handout. Download the handout by clicking on the link underneath the description for this tutorial. And we discovered that these are all ratios. The upper left-hand corner is our density triangle. Density is a ratio of mass per volume, where mass is given in grams and volume is given in milliliters. Our focus in this tutorial is to look at the mole triangle. Molar mass ratio, mm, is the ratio of mass per amount, where mass will be given in grams and amount will be given in moles. And the mole is a counting device. So turn to your supplemental packet and let's consider physical methods for counting. Here I have a hand with five fingers. One hand equals five fingers. We can write that as a ratio. The ratio can be written as one hand per five fingers or five fingers per one hand. Again, these are counting device ratios. And if there are 70 fingers in this room, how many complete hands of five fingers are there? To answer this question, we can show a math setup with number and unit to support our answer. Which counting ratio do we use in our math setup? One hand per five fingers or five fingers per one hand? We will use one hand per five fingers since we're trying to determine how many hands there are in this room if there are 70 fingers. One hand per five fingers times 70 fingers equals 14 hands. And we can see that our unit's fingers cancel out. And we're left with the image hand. And certainly raise your hand if you don't understand. And a good mantra is to raise your hand if you don't understand. And we can simplify our counting ratio by writing the following. One hand per five fingers times 70 fingers equals 14 hands, removing the hand pictogram. So how does this apply to the mole? First, we need to be familiar with counting devices of physical objects larger than atoms. And we are. One dozen of anything equals 12 units of anything. And we could draw a pictogram of that. 12 of anything per one dozen. Or we could write the ratio as one dozen per 12 units as a pictogram, which is equal to 12. And we can simplify our ratio as 12 per one dozen or one dozen per 12. And then we can answer a question like the following. A basket has 18 eggs. How many dozen eggs are contained in the basket? Well, we know there's 12 per one dozen, or one dozen per 12. We know there's 12 eggs per one dozen eggs, or one dozen eggs per 12 eggs. Thus, 18 eggs times one dozen eggs per 12 eggs is equal to 1.5 dozen eggs. And note that the units eggs cancel out. We could also cross out the units directly above, because anything above itself is equal to 1. Thus, eggs cancel with eggs, eggs cancel with eggs, eggs cancels with eggs, and when we multiply through, we multiply by 18 eggs per one dozen eggs.